welcome back. Now we're going to do something called VLSM. This is nothing new. This has been around forever. It stands for variable length subnet masking, which means that in a network, you're going to use different subnet masks to meet the range or as close as possible to the range or the number of IP addresses that you're going to use. Okay. Now, rules, just like anything else, rules, guidelines, whatever you want to call them, so like security, guidelines, policies, maybe. Because guidelines is just a guideline where you should follow whatever. Anyway, with VLSM, is the whole point is not to waste IP addresses, right? Not like when IPv4 started, what did they do? Hey, I need 1,000 IP addresses. Well, here's a default class B address with 65,000. Because they thought that, you know, IPv4 was here forever. Wrong. Okay, so that's why we ran out of IPv4 addresses a long time ago, but we're still using it. Anyway, that's another rant. Okay, so you start first from, this is what you're working with right up here, 172.16.1.0.0. That is your starting point, your zero network. That is your starting point, okay? This represents over here the third octet. This over here represents the fourth octet, okay? And listen, you can Google all you want. There's a million ways to do this. If you do it this way, again, is the easiest way to do it. You'll do it quick. You can do it in your friggin' head sometimes, okay? So try this way, okay? If not, leave comments, okay? And I'll answer it. All right, so our starting point, like I said, is gonna be 172.16.0.0. So we start there, but we need how many nodes? We need 300 nodes. 300 nodes. So we count for that. Well, we start from right to left. Right to left. Right? Start by 2. Double as you go. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256. Not enough. 512. Line. That's 512 hosts. But it's not 300. Better than 65,000. All right? So we're there. All right, cool. So what do we do with that? Well, let's find the broadcast first. This is the third octet. This is the third octet. What do we get? 172. And listen, I'm not going to write 172. Wow, let me get my eraser. My handy dandy eraser here. It's a futuristic eraser. Okay. X dot third octet 1. It's on the right side of the line. 1 plus 0 is 1. You add all these up. You can't just leave the fourth octet alone. Why would you do that? 25 is 255. If you add all those numbers up, it's 255. Anybody tells you anything else, they're lying. 255 and 0 is 255. Well, that's your broadcast. Awesome. So now we find the range. What's the range? I'm just going to use the two octets here, okay? The third and the fourth. What's after 0.0? 0.1. What's before? 1.255? 1.254. There are your 510, because 512 minus 2, right? 510. What's your CIDR? Okay, well, we know we're not working with these two. That's 8 and 8, that's 16. Then we go 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. 23. That's it. That is it. Now, when you're doing VLSM, remember, it's not to waste IP addresses. So we got to look at this last number here. 1.25, what comes after that? You max this out, so it'll reset, it'll change this one to 2 and reset that to 0. So your next starting point is 172.16.2.0. Yeah? And if you want to check if you're right, what do you do? Look at this. The incrementation is by 2. Third octet, it's 2. 2 and 0 is 2. It's like a check and balance sort of thing. All right, cool. So we got the next. We got the next starting point. Now we need 100. Okay. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. Right there. Boom. We stop right there. Okay. So we can't change this anymore. That's not going to change. We're working on the fourth octet. All right. So we got for the broadcast XX2.1. If you add all these bit values up, what do you get? 127. Am I that good of a mathematician? Hell no. There's one less 128. Why do you got to complicate things? Okay? 1 minus 120 is 127. There you go. All right. What's the range? Well, what's after 2.0? 2.1. What's before 2.127? 2.126. Cool. What is the CIDR, your new CIDR? Well, you turn on two more bits, it's 25. And if you want to count it, 8 and 8 and 8 is 24. And one more? 25. Because look, you added two more bits. Yeah? So what's next? What do you do next? Look at that guy. You got to use the next available IP address. What's after 2.127? 2.128. Okay. 172. That's 16, that 2, that 128. And lo and behold, look at this. You're incrementing by 128. 128 and 0, it's 128. Check and balance. All right, so now you need only 10 nodes. 10. Okay. 2, 4, 8, 16. Hey, right there. 16. Cool. So then, if you add these up, it's 15. 15 and 128 is 143, I believe. I'm pretty sure. 143, get a calculator. Check the math. Okay? Because if you increment by 16, it would be 144. That's why I know that. 2143. What's after 128? 2.129. What's before 2143? 2142. What's your new CIDR? Well, we got three octets that are fully on, that's 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. And you did add three more bits, 3 plus 25 is 28. That's VLSN. This is showing you the concept of VLSN. What to do in your test, what they like to do, and this is a simple example, all right? Capture this, take a snippet, whatever you want to do, all right? You should have been pausing the video so you can take notes. You'll have something like this. There's a router. I'm not Leonardo da Vinci, by no means. And you'll have still a serial cable in between you, okay? So I'll ask you, what CIDR would you use on a point-to-point connection? It will be something to the effect of, in a VLSN network, what subnet mask would you use to waste the least number of IP addresses? Okay? Trying to confuse the hell out of you. All right? On point to point, how many IP addresses do you need? You need one here, and you need one here. That's two, right? So you know you're going to be in the fourth octet. Okay? So let's just do a simple working it out here. You know, I don't care what it is over here. I need two IP addresses. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's count. 2, 4. Oh, -2 is 2. There we go. So we got 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So the answer is 30. That's it. That's all there's to it. That's all there is to it. Okay? But you need to know the concept of what I just did, just in case they give you something to work out. It's understanding, because variable length subnet masking is what we use in today's environment, right? Everybody's using CIDRs. Now, let me just get this out of the way. I would never do a CIDR notation, or I would never do VLSN in an internal network with private IP addresses. That's silly, okay? You may want a subnet because of VLANs, whatever, but I wouldn't make my life miserable. Right? It would be, let's say, using a class B address that can hold 65,534 hosts. Beautiful. I can say, okay, this number is 172.16.1.0.0, 1.0, 2.0, 3.0, 4.0, 5.0. I'm using 24s all the way, okay? Just to make my life simple, all right? It all depends. All depends. You may want to use a class A that holds 16 million plus addresses and do it that way. This is the 10,000 network, CIDR 24. This is the 10,100 network. I mean, however you want to do it. Just make sure you don't use the class C and then run out of IP addresses, all right? But VLSN is more towards the public. Do you know why we're using VLSN? Do you know why VLSN was created? Because they knew. They knew in the late 80s and 90s that IPv4 was dying. So they invented VLSM. They invented NAT, okay? So these are the kind of things that I do on my workshop, because every Wednesday, 1 to 3, for the rest of 2024, I'm gonna 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern time, I'm going to be doing workshops. And if you can't be there because you're working, it'll be recordings there. If you subscribe to GlobeEd.net, okay, you're gonna see that you go in there and we'll just go look at it, but subscribe to it. So when I put something new, you have it. I have all these courses, all these workshops that I do are recorded. I allow you to record, okay? All these are recorded and the recording's up there. So if you can't make it, you can still get the recording, you can still purchase it, okay? So you need to understand this. I'm getting students that are still having issues in the CCNA because they're asking them questions like this and they don't understand. And I don't blame the student. That's, hey, come to me, I'll explain it. They still, they're, what do you call that? Resistance to change syndrome or something like that. All right, point is, it's simple. Do it my way. I mean, I did not write this book for no reason, okay? Look how thin this book is. It's IPv6 and IPv4, subnetting and VLSM and route summarization right in here, because it's not full of fluff, okay? I'm not going to fill you full of fluff. All right, so do it this way and you'll be good to go, all right? Remember, please, if you can subscribe to the channel, that helps me a ton to help you guys to make more videos for you guys like this. And then hit the notification bell because I'm a little nutsy and I go on live whenever I, you know, sometimes I tell people about it, sometimes I just go live. So you'll know that I put a new video or I'm going live, you'll get that notification. So please subscribe and hit the notification bell. If you like it, hit like. If you don't like it, don't like it. Leave comments. So constructive criticism, so I can go ahead and do it better, explain it more in detail, whatever the case may be. I am here to teach you the easiest way and quickest way to get these things done. So when you go take your certification, you're not doing physics trying to figure out what's what. Okay? You guys have a good one. I'll see you in the next one.